southern trees bear a strange fruit, blood on the leaves and blood at the root, black bodies swinging in the southern breeze, strange fruit hanging from the poplar trees. Pastoral scene of the gallant south.
They still hate you! They still hate you! They still hate you!
Surrounding us, and hey, the colonel wants to know nobody color killed the man.
It is a precaution, Cobb. We can't have revenge killing, so we search for weapons.
Where did they find the sergeant, sir?
In the woods out by the junction. And so there aren't any rumors. Sergeant Waters was shot twice. We don't know that he was lynched. Twice. Once in the chest and a bullet in the head. You finished the footlockers?
Yes, sir. There aren't any weapons.
I didn't think there would be. At ease, men! Tech Sergeant Waters, in my opinion, served the 221st in his platoon in particular, with distinction. And I, for one, shall miss the man. But no matter what we think of the sergeant's death, we will not allow this incident to make us forget our responsibility to this uniform. We are soldiers, and our war is with the Nazis and the Japs, not the civilians of Tynan. Any enlisted man found with unauthorized weapons will be immediately subject to summary court-martial. The Sergeant Waters' replacement will not be assigned for several weeks. Until that time, you will all report to Sergeant Dorsey and C Company. Any questions? Corporal Cobb will be Barris NCO.
Who do they think did it, sir?
This time there are no suspects.
You know the Klan did it, sir.
Were you an eyewitness, soldier?
Well, who else go around killing Negroes in the South? They lynched Jefferson the week I got there, sir. And the Signal Corps got Daniels 2 months later.
Henson! Unless you saw it, you will keep your opinions to yourself. Is that clear? And that's in order. It also applies to everybody else!
Yes, sir!
You men who have detail this afternoon, report to the orderly room for your assignments. The rest of you are assigned to the colonel's quarters. Clean up your tail. Cobb, I want to see you in my office at 1350 hours.
Yes, sir.
As of 0600 hours this morning, the town of Tynan is placed off limits to all military personnel.
Oh, come on, man.
The Friday night dance has also been canceled.
Cap.
Okay. Some of the officers are going to the colonel. I can't promise anything. Right now, it's canceled.
Tear up!
As you were.
Hey, they still out there, Wilkie?
Yep, they got the whole place around.
What the hell they think we going to town with? Mops and ditch rags?
Y'all new recruits know what the colonel's cleanup detail is, don't you? Shoveling horse shit in his stable.
Ain't no different from what we've been doing.
Made you barracks commanding chief, huh? Now don't get like old Stoney. What are you doing?
Scratching.
Look, Taylor knows the Klan did it, and I hope that y'all know that too. Then why them MPs outside with rifles? Why hold us prisoner? They scared we gonna kill a couple of them Peckerwood Smalls. Calm down, man.
Hey, Smalls, you wanna play some coon can?
Hey, Peterson, I think Eva done gave me the crabs, man.
Oh, man, the woman, you fine? It's a wonder your nuts ain't fell off. Crabs? Man, you probably got lice. Ticks, please. Bed bugs, tapeworms.
Shut up, Henson. Hey, Pete, I ain't fooling, man.
Man, get some powder down at the PA.
Hey, which one of y'all want to play me some cards? Me and Peterson finna go to the mess hall. What's up, old Pete? Mm.
Hey, look. I thought all you could do was play gopher.
Yeah, whose ass you gonna kiss down? I mean, now your number one ass is dead.
That sound like something CJ was saying.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Well, I'm the one that lost 3 stripes, and I'm the only man in here with kids. So when the man said jump, I jumped.
Hey, don't put your wife and kids between you and Waters' ass, man.
Look, I wanted my stripes back.
Man, I'm going to sick call after child.
Look. Y'all ain't never had nothing. And that's why you don't understand a man like me. There was a time I was a sergeant major, you know?
Oh, B-girl done slipped Cobb the crab.
How you gonna explain that to the girl back home, Corporal?
Huh? How you gonna tell that fine, thick, dime mama? All the river you bring home from this war is a purple heart from crab fights.
Well, don't y'all give a damn.
Oh, what's the matter, Smalls?
The man's dead. He was alive last night.
Damn, I saw him too. At least I know he died good and drunk.
Oh, what's the matter with y'all?
The man got himself lynched. We in the South ain't a goddamn thing we can do about it. You heard the captain. Now don't go act like we done something to be guilty of. Just hope we get lucky enough to get shipped out of this hellhole into the war. Besides, whoever did kill the man, they ain't kill much of nobody no way.
The man deserved better than that.
Look, everybody feels rotten, Smalls, but it won't bring that man back, so let's forget about it.
Yeah, why don't you just walk it off, man?
Yeah, go turn the smoke machine on and let the fire make you feel like you're in London or something.
Or let Cobb bring his evil over. She'll take his mind off Waters and give him a bonus in crabs.
Oh, blue balls, the clap, syphilis, fever blisters, piles, pimples, alcohols, the cooties.
Davenport, Captain, United States Army, attached to the 243rd Military Police Corps Unit, Fort Neal, Louisiana. I'm a lawyer that the segregated armed services couldn't find a place for. My job in this war? Policing colored troops. One morning during mid-April, 1944, a colored tech sergeant, Vernon C. Waters, assigned to the 221st Chemical Smoke Generating Company, stationed here before a transfer to Europe, was brutally shot to death in a wooded section off the New Post Road and the junction of Highway 51, just 200 yards from the Colored NCO Club, by a person or persons unknown. Naturally, the unofficial consensus was the local Ku Klux Klan, and for that reason, I was told at the time, Colonel Barton Nivens ordered the military police to surround the enlisted men's quarters. Then he instructed all his company commanders to initiate a thorough search of all personal property for unauthorized knives, guns, weapons of any kind. You see, 90% of the colonel's command, all of the enlisted men stationed here, are Negroes. And the colonel felt, and I suppose justly, that once word of the sergeant's death spread among his troops, there might be some retaliation against the white citizens of Tynan. What he did worked. There was no retaliation and no racial incidents. The week after the killing took place, several correspondents from the Negro press wrote lead articles about it, but the headlines faded. The NAACP got me involved in this. Rumor has it Thurgood Marshall ordered an immediate investigation of the killing, and the Army, pressured by Secretary of War Stinson, rather randomly ordered Colonel Nivens to initiate a preliminary inquiry into the sergeant's death. Now the colonel, he didn't want to rehash the murder, but complied with the Army's orders by instructing the Provost Marshal my CO, Major Hines, to conduct a few question and answer sessions among the men of Sergeant Waters' platoon and file a report. The matter was to be given the lowest priority. The case was mine. 5 minutes later. It was 4 to 5 weeks after his death, the month of May. Captain.
Forgive me for occasionally staring, Davenport. You're the first colored officer I ever met. I heard you arrived a month ago, and you're a bit startling. I mean you no offense. Well, we'll be getting some of you as replacements, but we don't expect them until next month. Sit down, Davenport. You came out of Fort Benning in 43.
Yes.
And they assigned a lawyer to the military police? I'm infantry, and I've been with the engineers, field artillery, and signal corps. This is some army. Where'd you graduate law school?
Howard University.
Your daddy a rich minister or something? I graduated the Point. We didn't have any Negroes at the Point. I never saw a Negro until I was 12 or 13. You like the army, I suppose, huh?
Captain, did you see my orders?
I saw them right up to Colonel Niven, sent them to Major Hines. I sent my orderly to the barracks and told him to have the men waiting for you.
Thank you.
I didn't know at the time that Major Hines was assigning a Negro to Davenport. My preparations were made in the belief you'd be a white man. I think it only fair to tell you, had I known what Hines intended, I would have requested the immediate suspension of this investigation. May I speak freely?
You haven't stopped yet, Captain.
Look, how far do you think you can get even if you succeed? These local people are not going to charge a white man in this parish on the strength of an investigation conducted by a Negro. And Nivens and Hines know that. The Colonel doesn't give a damn about finding the men responsible for this thing, and they're making a fool of you. Can't you see that? And take off those sunglasses.
I intend to carry out my orders, and I like these glasses. They're like MacArthur's.
You go near that sheriff's office in Tynan in your uniform, carrying a briefcase, looking and sounding white, and charging local people, and you'll be found just as dead as Sergeant Waters. People around here don't respect the color.
I know that.
Do you know how many times I've asked Nivens to look into this killing? Every day since it happened, Davenport. Major Hines didn't tell you that.
Do you suspect someone, Captain?
Don't play cat and mouse with me, soldier.
Captain, like it or not, I'm all you've got. I've been ordered to look into Sergeant Waters' death, and I intend to do exactly that.
Can I tell you a little story? Before you were assigned here, Nivens got us together after dinner one night, and all we did was discuss Negroes in the officer ranks. We all commanded Negro troops, but no one ever came face to face with colored officers. There were a lot of questions that night. For example, your quarters had to be equal to ours, but we had none. No mess hall for you. Anyway, Jed Harris was the only officer that defended it. My own feelings were mixed. The only Negroes I've ever known have been subordinates. You know, my father hired the first Negro I ever saw, a man named Colfax, to help him fix a shed one summer. He was a nice man, and he worked hard, and he did a good job, too. But I never met a Negro with any education until I graduated the Point, and hardly an officer of equal rank. So I frankly didn't know how I'd feel. Until right now. And I don't want to offend you, but I just cannot get used to it. The bars, the uniform. Being in charge just doesn't look right on me.
Captain, are you through?
You can ask Hines for another assignment. This case is not for you. By the time you overcome the obstacles to your race, this case would be dead.
I got it. And I am in charge. All your orders instruct you to do is cooperate.
I won't be made a fool of, Davenport. Ellis! You're right. There is no need to discuss this any further.
Yes, sir.
Captain Davenport will need assistance with the men. I can't prevent that, Davenport, but I intend to do all I can to have this so-called investigation stopped.
Do what you like. If there's nothing else, you'll excuse me, won't you, Captain?
Glad I met you, Captain.
We heard it was you, sir.
Well, you know how the grapevine is. Sad thing what happened to the Sarge?
What's on the grapevine about the killing?
Well, we figured the Klan, they ain't too crazy about us Ten Yinks in this part of the country.
Is there anything on the grapevine about trouble in the town before Sergeant Waters was killed?
Not that I know of before. After. There were some rumors around the post. A couple of our guys from the Tink Corps wanted to drop them Shermans right into Tyler. Then I guess that's when somebody told you that two officers did it. I figured that's why the colonel surrounded our barracks.
Was the rumor confirmed? I didn't hear that.
Not that
did anything ever come of it?
No, not that I know of, sir.
Thanks, Ellis. I better start seeing the men. You set this up?
Yes, sir.
Good. Are they ready?
The captain instructed A-Bot and the Sarge platoon to be here, sir. He said he'd be getting started this morning.
Before he found out, huh?
What's that, sir?
Nothing. Call the first man in, Corporal. And stay loose. I might need you.
Yes, sir. Sir, may I say something?
Yes.
It is good. I mean, so good to see one of us wearing them captain bars, sir.
Thank you.
Private Wilkin!
Yes, sir!
Our captain wants to see you.
Yes, sir. Yes, indeedy. Private James Wilkie reports his order, sir.
At ease. Have a seat, Private. That'll be all, Corporal. Private Wilkie, I am Captain Davenport.
Oh, everybody knows that, sir. You're all we got down here. I always on the detail got your quarters together, sir.
I am conducting an investigation into the events surrounding Sergeant Waters' death. Everything you say to me will go in my report, but that report is confidential.
I understand, sir.
How long did you know Sergeant Waters?
About a year. I remember it was March 5th. It was 2 years to the day after I met Staff Sergeant. He arrived, sir. You see, basically this is a baseball team out here. All the men here played in the Negro League, so naturally the Army put us all together. And we'd be assigned different jobs, a dump truck, motor pool, and we get all the dirty jobs too, garbage cleanup. But on Saturdays, we were whooping the hell out of them on the baseball diamond. I was hitting 352 myself. We had a boy, C.J. Memphis, he hit the ball from Fort Neill to Berlin, Germany, or Tokyo, if he was batting right-handed. To set the sergeant here to manage the team. He was a field artillery gunnery sergeant. He had a quad grill from the First War, too.
What kind of man was he?
All spit and polish, sir.
Well, tell me about him.
Well, he took my stripes, but I was in the wrong, sir.
Sergeant Wilkie, you're a non-commissioned officer in the army of a country at war. The penalty for being drunk on duty is severe in peacetime. So don't give me none of that poor colored folks can't do nothing unless they're drunk shit as an excuse. You're supposed to set an example for your men. That's why I'm sending you to jail for 10 days. And take those goddamn stripes. Teach you a lesson. You're in the army. Colored folks always running off at the mouth about what they're gonna do if the white man gives them a chance. You get it? What do you do with it? You wind up drunk on duty. I don't blame the white man. Why should they put colors and whites together in this war? You can't even be trusted to guard your own quarters. No wonder they treat us all like dogs. my sight. Private!
What about the other men?
The southern boys caught a little hell. Sarge said he was from up north somewhere. He's a good soldier, sir. I'm from Detroit myself, born and raised. Joe Louis started in Detroit. You know that, sir?
What about the southerners?
Well, Sarge wasn't exactly crazy about him, except for CJ.
Who's low down? A low-down, dirty shame. I said it's a low-down,
Mississippi
boy. A low-down, dirty shame.
They say we're fighting Hitler, but they won't let us in the game. Hey, he worked harder and faster than anybody. Wasn't a man on the team didn't like him. Sarge took to him as soon as he seen him. He said, Wilkie?
Well,
what have we got here?
A guitar playing man. Boy, you ever hear of Blind Willie Reynolds? Son House? Henry Sims?
You heard that place off?
Well, every one of them. See, I was stationed down in Mississippi a couple of years ago. Now, you're from down that way, aren't you?
Yes, sir.
They used to play down at the Bandana Club, right outside of Camp J.J. Riley.
I played there once.
Well, ain't that something? I used to go there myself from time to time. Folks used to come from all over. Place was always dark and smoky. Dancers would be in there sweating and screaming. Guitar pickers would be in there shouting. Ooh, it'd get crazy in there sometimes. Yeah, it reminded me of a place I used to go to when I was in France during the First War. Women, the whiskey. A place called the Cafe Napoleon.
Really like the blues, huh?
Oh, there ain't any other kind of music. Where'd you learn how to play so good, boy? I came by here the other day and I heard that picking. Asked one of the men and they told me it was you.
My daddy taught me song.
Well, you played pretty good, boy. Wasn't that good, Wilkie?
Yes, indeed, Sarge. I basically agree with Sarge. He was a good man, sir. Good to his men. He'd talk about his wife and kids all the time. He used to write home to him every day. Don't know why anybody want to kill the Sarge, sir.
Hey, Wilkie. You know what I'm gonna get that boy of mine for his birthday? One of them Schwinn bikes. He's gonna be 12. Time sure flies, don't it? Let me show you something.
He was always pulling out snapshots.
See, my wife, she let one of the neighbors take this a couple of weeks ago. He's sure grown fast.
Yeah, he's over your wife's shoulder.
I just hope this boy doesn't have to be a soldier.
It was good enough for you.
I couldn't do any better. And this here army's the closest I figured that the white man would let me get to any sort of authority. No, the army's not for this boy. See, when this war's over, things are gonna change, Wilkie. And I want him to be ready for it. My daughter, too. That's why I'm sending them to some big white college. Let them rub elbows with the whites. Learn the white man's language. See how they do things. Otherwise, we'll be left behind. You can see it in the army. White man's running circles around us.
Yeah, a lot of us ain't get the same chances in schooling as the white folks got.
That ain't no excuse, Wilkie. Most niggas don't care. Tomorrow don't mean nothing to them. My daddy shoveled coal out of the back of a wagon all of his life. Couldn't read or write, but he saw to it that we could. Not having ain't no reason for not getting.
Yeah, you can't get pee from a rock, Sarge.
You just like the rest of them, Wilkie. Now, I thought busting you would teach you something. You have to challenge this man in his arena. Use his weapons. Don't you know that? We need lawyers and doctors and generals and senators. Stop thinking like a nigger.
All I said...
Is the equipment ready for tomorrow's
game? Yeah.
Good. You can go now, Wilkie. It's an order.
You could be warm 1 minute. Ice the next.
How did you feel about it?
Nah, he was all right. You could always borrow a 10 spot off him if you needed it.
Did you see the sergeant any time immediately preceding his death?
Well, it wasn't too much before. A couple of us was over at the NCO club. Sarge was juicing kind of heavy.
Did Waters drink a lot?
No more than most. Sir, when they found the Sarge, did he still have all his stripes and insignia on his uniform?
I don't recall it being mentioned in my preliminary report. Why?
Well, it's kind of strange. The Klan don't like to see us in these uniforms. They usually take the stripes and insignia off before they lynch us.
Thank you, Private.
That'll be all for now.
Sir, can you do anything about allotment checks? My wife didn't get hers last month.
There's nothing I can do directly. Did you see the finance officer?
Well, yeah.
Well, I'll mention it to Captain Taylor.
All right. You want me to send the next man in?
Yes.
Next!
Private First Class Melvin Peterson reporting as ordered, sir.
Sit down, Private. Do you know why I'm here?
Yes, sir.
Fine. Everything you tell me is confidential, so I want you to speak as freely as possible. Where are you from?
Hollywood, California. By way of Alabama. I enlisted in 42. I thought we'd get a chance to fight.
Did you know Sergeant Waters well?
No, sir. He was already with the company when I got assigned here. And us common GIs don't mix well with the NCOs.
Were you on the baseball team?
Yes, sir. I played shortstop.
Did you like the sergeant?
No, sir.
Beg your pardon, sir? Captain Taylor, he'd like to see you at his office at once.
Did he say why?
No, sir. Just that you need to see him immediately.
Tell him to stick around. When I'm finished with the captain, I'll be back.
Yes, sir.
You feel like walking, Private? We can continue this on the way. Why didn't you like the sergeant?
Well, it goes back to the team, sir. See, I got here in, baseball season had started, so it had to be June of last year. And the team won maybe 9 out of 10 games in a row. And there was a rumor that they would even get a chance to play the Yankees in exhibition. So when I got assigned to a team like that, sir, I mean, I felt good. Anyway, old Stone-Ass.
Stone-Ass?
Oh, I'm the only one who called him that, sir. Sergeant Waters, sir.
Respect his rank with me, Private.
I didn't mean any offense, sir. Well, the sergeant and that brown-nosed Wilkie, they ran the team in. And like it was a chain gang, sir. A chain gang.
Yeah! Yeah! Hey, you guys see the look on the umpire's face when CJ hit that home run? Man, I thought he got in the spotty turf so bad.
Sir, that fat bastard right. Some of those pitches he called for strikes was way over my head.
Mm-hmm. Sure know. Hey, CJ, who was that fine river hit thing you was talking to, homie?
Speaking of women. Got to write my lady a letter.
She looked mighty good to me, CJ.
Hey, y'all heard Henson? Hey, Henson, you ain't had a woman since a woman had you.
No, all she did was ask you for my autograph. Looked like she was asking you for more than that. You see him, Smalls, leaning against the fence, hauling that woman's face, breathing heavy.
Man, if Smalls couldn't see good enough to catch that ground ball right with his glove, how are you supposed to see CJ all over there by the fence?
I lost it in the sun. On the ground. Look, we beat him 9-1. Y'all be quiet. I'm trying to ask this man about a woman he was with. Man, she had tits like 2 helmets. Try to give that gal what she asked for. Mm-hmm. She'd give me something I ain't want. Them V gals get you a bad case of clap. Besides, she won't but 16.
Mm. Hey, you ought to introduce her to Henson. 16 by his speed.
Round home, there's a fellow folks used to call Little Jimmy One Leg on account of his thing was so big. But 2 years ago, old young pretty little thing laid a clap on Jimmy so bad, he lost the one good leg he had. Now folks just call him Little. That young thing talking to me ain't look so clean.
Dirty clean, she had a white boy look.
Eyes popping out they sockets, wasn't it? Remind me of that picture last week. The one from 35th Orderlies? Mm-hmm. That one that everybody claimed was so good. But after 12 straight hits, he looked the same way.
It may seem funny to y'all, but when me and Pete had duty at the ordnance mess hall, seemed like that same white picture
was the one who started doing the name calls.
Forget right. That dude in ordinance and listen to this.
Dear Lewis. Heard that, Lewis.
Read the damn letter.
Dear Lewis, you and the boys keep up the good work. All of us here at home are praying and inspired by you and this great cause. We know the Nazis and the Japs can't be stopped unless we all work together. So tell the buddies to press forward and witness war. All of our hopes for the future go with you, Lewis. Love, Maddie. Think I'm in love with the CP of Winston Churchill. What kind of letter do I write a nut like that?
Send her around the ammunition in the bayonet, Lewis.
You ought to listen with small kids. Every time we beat them at baseball, they get back at us any way they can.
Kid, it's worth it to me, though, just to wipe those superior smiles off their faces.
Yeah, I don't know. Seems like it makes it that much harder for us.
When they tell me a couple of them big-time Negroes is on the verge of getting us all together, colored and white. They say they want one army.
Forget that, CJ. White folks never integrate no army. Yeah.
Well, if they do, I'm gonna be ready for it. Well, I got me a red zoot suit.
Look at
and some patent leather shoes.
And my woman sitting waiting for the day we hear the news. Oh, Lord.
Come on, CJ.
Lord.
Guitar playing, sitting around the shack music today, CJ. Now I want you men out of those baseball uniforms and into work clothes. You're to report to me in front of the officers' club at 1300 hours. We have a work detail. We're painting the officers' lobby.
The officers can't paint their own club?
Hell no, Smalls. Let the great color cleanup company do it. Our motto is, anything you don't want to do, the color troops will do for you.
Anything you don't want to do, the color troops will do for you. Anything you don't want to do, the color troops will do for you.
That's enough! My son, that's enough! Knock it off!
Well, when do we get a break, Sarge? We just played 9 innings of baseball.
We can't go into the place. Why the hell should we paint it?
Amen, brother.
Let me tell you fancy-ass baseball-playing Negro something. The reasons for any orders given by a superior officer, none of y'all's business. You obey them. This country's at war, and you niggas are soldiers, nothing else. So baseball teams win or lose, you get no special privileges. They need to work some of you niggas till your legs fall off. And something else. When I tell you to do something, I want it done. Is that clear? Now, Wilkie's gonna take those funky shirts you have on, take them over to the laundry. Could smell you suckers before I hit the field.
What kind of colored man are you?
I'm a soldier, Peterson. First, last, and always. I'm the kind of colored man that don't like lazy, shiftless Negroes.
You ain't gotta come in here and call us names.
Well, the Nazis call you Schwarzer. You gonna tell them that they hurt your little feelings?
Don't look to me like we can do too much to them Nazis with paintbrushes, Saul.
CJ!
Yes, Saul?
You trying to mock me, CJ?
No, Saul.
Good. Because whatever a low-class, ignorant geechee like you has to say isn't worth listening to. Now, is it? Is it?
I reckon not, Saul.
You're a creep, Waters.
Well, he's something else. Wilkie, he hasn't been in the company more than a month, and already he's everybody's champion.
Sarge is just joking, Pete. He don't mean no harm. Yeah,
he does. We take enough from them white boys.
Yes, you do. And if it wasn't for you southern niggas bowing, scraping, scratching your heads, white folks wouldn't think we were all fools.
Where you from, England?
Peace.
Well, you got something to say, Henson?
Nothing, sir.
Well, you got a real comic streak in you there, Peterson. Yes, sir. Hey, Wilkie. Looks like we got ourselves a real wise-ass Alabama boy here.
Yes, sir.
Don't get smart, nigga.
Fucking hands off me.
You want to hit old Sergeant Waters, boy? Come on. Come on! Please, nigga!
T-Hut!
At ease. What's going on here, Sergeant?
It's going over the manual of arms with the men, sir. Anything in particular you need? Something I can help you with?
Nothing. Men, I congratulate you on the game you won today. We only have 7 more to play, and if we win them, we'll be the first team in Fort Neill history to play the Yanks in exhibition. Everyone in the regiment is counting on you. Times like these, morale is important, and winning can help a lot of things. Sergeant, as far as I'm concerned, they have the rest of the day off.
No, I'm begging your pardon, sir. These men don't need any time off. They need all the work they can get. Our boys in the north of Africa, they're not getting any time off. Besides, we have orders to report to the officers' club at 1300 hours for a paint detail.
Who issued that order?
Major Harris did, sir.
I'll speak to the major.
I don't think it's a good idea to get a colored NCO mixed in the middle of you officers, sir.
I said I'd speak to him, Sergeant.
Yes, sir.
I respect the men's duty to service, but they need time off.
Yes, sir.
Men, that was a great game of baseball you played out there today. And that catch you made in center field, Memphis? How the hell did you get up so high?
Say I got bird in my blood, sir.
American Eagle, I hope.
No, sir. Crow. Man told my daddy the day I was born, the shadow of a crow's wings will fly.
Men, I'll say it again. You played superbly. Sergeant! As you were.
Well, you geeky's really something. I'll tell you. How long of a story were you gonna tell that man, CJ? My God. Peterson! I didn't forget about you, boy. Time to teach you a lesson.
Why don't you drop that voice?
No, but I'm gonna drop you out behind the barracks. Wilkie, go out and make sure it's all set up.
All right, you want me to get the rest of the NCO?
Yep. Now I'm gonna go outside, and I'm gonna wait for you, Geechee. And when you come out, I'm gonna whip your black southern ass. And I'm gonna let the whole company watch. You need to learn respect, how to talk to your betters. You fight hard, yeah? Because I'm gonna try to bust your fucking head open. And the rest of you men, get out of those goddamn uniforms like I said!
Pete, you better fight him.
Trying to warn you, man. You ain't do nothing. Don't do it, Pete. He'll fight you dirty.
You don't want to do it.
You gonna fight in my place, Scott?
Take some of this father's dust, Pete. Just a picture make you strong as a bull. They say it come from the city of Czar. Now, I seen a man use this stuff and pull a full-grown mule out of sinkhole all by himself.
Get the hell out of here with that backwater crap! Can't you stick up for yourself? You let that bastard treat you like a dog.
As long as his hands ain't on me, he ain't done me no harm, Pete. Calling names ain't nothing. I know what I is. Sarge ain't so bad. Been good to me.
The man despises you.
Sarge? You wrong, Pete. Plus, I kind of feel sorry for Sarge.
Any man who ain't sure where he belong must be in a whole lot of pain.
Don't y'all care? Don't nobody like it, Pete. And once you're here longer, I mean, what are we supposed to do? This is the army, and the Sarge got all the stripes.
Look, Pete, if you want, I'll get the captain. You ain't gotta go out there and get your head beat.
No, no. Somebody's gotta fight him.
Well, slow down. A low down, dirty shame. I said it's a low down. A low down, dirty shame.
We've been playing this here army, but he ain't even learned to play the game.
Beat me pretty bad that day, sir. The man was crazy.
Was the incident ever reported?
I never reported it. I know I should have, but he left me alone after that. So I just played ball.
Did you see Waters the night he died?
No, sir. Me and Smalls had guard duty.
Thank you, Private. That'll be all for now. By the way, did the team ever get to play the Yankees?
No, sir. We lost the last game to the sanitation company.
Captain. Captain.
I asked you back here because I wanted you to see the report I sent to Colonel Nivens to have your investigation terminated.
What?
I wanted you to see that my reasons have nothing to do with you personally. My request will not hurt your Army record in any way. There are other things to consider in this case.
Only the color of my skin, Captain.
I want the people responsible for killing one of my men found in jail, Davenport.
So do I.
Then give this up. Whites down here won't see their duty or justice. They'll see you. And once they do, the law, due process, it all goes. And what is the point of continuing an investigation that can't possibly get at the truth?
Captain, my orders are very specific. So unless you want charges brought against you for interfering in a criminal investigation, stay the hell out of my way and leave me and my investigation alone.
Don't take yourself too seriously, Davenport. You couldn't find an officer within 500 miles who would convey charges to a court-martial board against me for something like that, and you know it.
Maybe not. But I'd see to it that your name, rank, and duty station got into the Negro press. Yeah. Let a few colored newspapers call you a Negro hater. Make you an embarrassment to the United States Army, Captain. Like Major Albright at Fort Jefferson, and you'll never command troops again or wear more than them captain bars in that uniform, Mr. West Point.
I'll never be more than a Captain Davenport because I won't let them get away with things like dismissing Waters' death. I've been a commanding officer at 3 outfits. I raised hell and all of them. So threatening me won't change my request. Let the Negro press print that I don't like being made a fool of with phony investigations.
There are 2 white officers involved in this, Captain. Aren't there?
I want them in jail. Out of the Army. And there is no way you can get them charged or court-martialed or put away. The white officers on this post won't let you. They won't let me.
Why wasn't there any mention of them in your preliminary report? I checked my own summary on the way over here, Captain, and nothing. You think I'm gonna let you get away with this? Why?
I couldn't prove the men in question had anything to do with it.
Why didn't you report it?
I was ordered not to. Nivens and Hines. The doctors took 2.45 caliber bullets out of Waters. Army issue. But remember what it was like that morning. If these men had thought a white officer had killed Waters, there would have been a slaughter. Cobb reported the incident innocently the night before. Suddenly, it was all over the fort.
Who were they, Captain? I want their names.
Byrd and Wilcox. Birds and Ordnance and Wilcox is with the 12th Hospital Group. I was captain of the guard the night Waters was killed. At about 2100 hours, Cobb came into my office and said that he had seen Waters and two white officers fighting outside the colored NCO club. I called your office, and when I couldn't get two MPs, I started over myself to break things up. But when I got there, there was no Waters, no officers. I checked the officer's billet and found Byrd and Wilcox in bed. Several officers verified that they'd been in since 2130. I then told Cobb to go back to the barracks and forget it.
What made you do that?
Well, at the time, there was no reason to believe anything was wrong. Waters wasn't found until the following morning. I told the colonel about the report and about the night before, and I was told, since the situation at the fort was potentially dangerous, to keep my mouth shut until it blew over. Well, he agreed to let me question Byrd and Wilcox. But I've asked him for a follow-up investigation every day since it happened. When I saw you, I exploded. It was like he was laughing at me.
Then you never believed the Klan was involved.
No. Now can you see why this thing needs someone else?
Tell me what they told you. Byrd and Wilcox.
They're not gonna let you charge those two men.
Tell me what they told you.
They were coming off bivouac. We saw them outside the club.
Well, if it ain't the white boys. And it wasn't like we were looking for trouble, Captain. Were we, Wilcox? White boys all starched and stiff. Wanted everybody to learn that symphony shit. That's what you were saying in France. Well, I listened to you. So, am I all right now? Am I?
Boy! You better straighten up and salute when you see an officer. Or you'll find yourself without those stripes.
Will you look at this, nigga?
Come to attention, Sergeant! That's an order!
No, sir. I ain't straightening up for y'all no more! I ain't doing nothing white folks ain't do no more! No more, no more, no more, no more. No
sir, more. I thought the man was crazy!
No more.
What'd you think, Wilcox?
He did appear to be intoxicated, sir. Out of his mind, almost. Byrd, listen to me.
Did they see anyone else in the area?
No. I asked him what they did next.
I told that nigga to shut up!
No! Following behind y'all. Look what it's done to me. I hate myself.
Don't blame us, boy. God made you black, not me.
You know, my daddy used to tell
me... Hey, Sergeant, get hold of yourself!
Shh, listen.
I gave you an order, nigga!
My daddy used to say, don't talk like this. Talk like that. Don't live over here. Live over there. I killed for you, and nothing's changed!
You kill a man! He's sick! Leave him alone!
I've done everything! But what has changed? I've done everything!
I'm gonna bust his black ass to Buck Private! I'm gonna blow this coward's head off!
I've done everything!
There are good men!
Bird! Killing for you, nigga! Get their guts! I'll blow to hell for you!
Bird!
Did they shove Waters again?
No. But Byrd's got a history of scrapes with Negroes. They told me they left Waters at 2110, and everyone in the officer's billet verified they were in by 2130, and neither man left. Byrd had duty the following morning, and Wilcox was scheduled at the hospital at 0500 hours. Both men reported for duty.
I don't believe it.
I couldn't shake their stories.
That's nothing more than officers lying to protect two of their own, and you know it. I'm gonna arrest and charge both of them, Captain. And you may consider yourself confined to your quarters, pending my charges against you.
What charges?
It was your duty to go over Niven's head if you had to.
You could arrest Colonel Niven's too, Davenport? He's part of their alibi. He was there when they came in. Played poker from 2100 to 0300 hours the following morning. The Colonel, your Major Hines, Shaq Callahan, Major Callahan, and Jed Harris. And Jed wouldn't lie for either of them.
They're all lying.
Well, look, prove it, hotshot. I told you all I know. Now you go out and prove it.
I will, Captain. You can bet your sweet ass on that. I will. The Allies are making final preparations for the invasion of Europe. Invasion. Even the sound of it made Negroes think that we'd be in it, be swept into Europe in the waves of men and equipment. I know I felt it. We hadn't seen a lot of action except in North Africa or Sicily. But the rumor in orderly rooms that spring was, pretty soon most of us would be in combat. Somebody said Ike wanted to find out if the colored boys could fight. Shit. We've been fighting all along, right here, in these small southern towns. I don't have the authority to arrest a white private without a white officer present. And then I get a case like this? There was no way I wouldn't see this through to its end. And after my first 24 hours, I wasn't doing too badly. I had two prime suspects, a motive and opportunity. I went to Colonel Nivens and convinced him that word of Byrd and Wilcox's involvement couldn't be kept a secret any longer. However, before anyone in the press could accuse him of complicity, I would silence all suspicions and pursue the investigation openly on his orders. Yes, sir, Colonel. You can even send along a white officer. Not Captain Taylor, though. I think he's a little too close to the case. Sir. Colonel Nivens gave me permission to question Byrd and Wilcox. And after succeeding so easily, I decided to spend some time finding out more about Waters and Memphis. Somehow, the real drama seemed to be there. And my curiosity wouldn't allow me to ignore it. Sit down, Private. Your name is Lewis Henson, is that right?
Yes, sir.
Tell me what you know about Sergeant Waters and C.J. Memphis. Is there something wrong?
No, sir. I'm just surprised you know about that.
Why?
Because you're an officer.
And?
Well, officers, they appear, sir. Us enlisted men, well, we down here. C.J. and Waters, well, that was between enlisted men. Guess there ain't no such thing as a secret around color folk. Not that it was a secret, sir. Look, they ain't much to tell. The Sarge, he ain't like CJ. When I got to the company last May, first person I seen him chew out was CJ.
Go on.
Is that an order, sir?
Does it have to be?
Look, sir, I don't like tattletelling, and I don't mean no offense, but I ain't too crazy about speaking to no officers. Colored or white?
It's an order, Henson.
I mean, CJ just couldn't move fast enough for him. Said he ain't have enough fire under his behind on the field.
You on the team?
Pitcher. I mean, he stayed on CJ all the time. Every single thing, it seemed to me. And then the shootings went down, CJ caught all the hell.
What shooting? What shooting?
The shootings at the Williams Golden Palace, sir. Here last year. Happened last year, way before you got here. Toward the end of the baseball season. The night it happened, a whole lot of gunshots went off over by the barracks. I had gotten drunk over at the enlisted man club. So when I got back to the barracks, well, I just sat in the stupor.
What the hell's going on? Don't they know a man needs his sleep?
You sure you saw someone?
Well, I saw something, sir.
And what did you do?
I sat, sir. I was juiced. Them gunshots were none of my business, plus I wasn't sure what I seen in the first place. Next thing I know, Sergeant Waters walked in.
Let's go! Get him up!
Get out, Ben!
Get up!
Let's go! Get him up! Get out, Ben! Come on, let's go! Get out, Ben!
Get him up!
Come on!
Unask them, bums!
Let's go!
Get up! Ten head! Let's go! There's been a shooting. One of ours bucked the line down at Williams' payphone. Three soldiers are dead. Two colored and one white MP. Now the man that bucked the line, he shot and killed that MP. And them white boys started shooting everybody. That's how ours got shot. Now this low-down nigga we're looking for got chased down here. He was almost caught. Until somebody in these barracks started shooting at the men that was chasing him. So we got ourselves a vicious, murdering piece of black trash in here somewhere. And a couple of people that helped him. Well, now, if any of you are in this, I want you to step forward now. So all you baseball playing Negroes are innocent, huh? Okay. Wilkie, make the search. Ice front, ice front!
Get out. I don't want that creep in my stomach.
You don't talk at attention. I almost hope it is some of you Geechies. Get rid of some of you Southern niggas. Anything yet?
No.
Memphis, you in this?
No, sir, Saul.
How many of you went out tonight?
Well, I was at Williams around 7. Got me a pair of lucky stripes. I didn't call home, though.
I was there this morning.
Didn't I say tonight, Uncle?
Ooh! Got something.
Where'd you find it?
No, man.
CJ, this yours?
You know it ain't mine, Sarge.
Come here, boy. Come here. Still warm. How come it's under your bunk?
Anybody could have put it there, Sarge.
Who? Ooh, maybe this 45 climbed into a window, took a look around, walked past Cobb's bunk, and decided to snuggle up under your bunk, huh? Or maybe it's voodoo. Or some of that farmer's dust from around your neck, huh?
That pistol ain't mine.
Liar!
No, sir, Sarge, I hate guns. Make me feel bad just to see a gun.
You're under arrest. Wilkie, take him to the stockade.
Get your stuff.
CJ couldn't hurt a fly, Waters, you know that.
I found a weapon, soldier. You just stay out of my way.
God damn it, Waters, you know it ain't him.
How? How do I know that?
Well, right before you got here, I thought I seen someone sneak in here.
You were drunk when you left the club. I saw you myself.
Yeah, yeah, how you know it wasn't him? I was here all night. CJ didn't go out.
No, no. No, we got the right man. You think he's innocent, don't you? C.J. Memphis, playing cotton picker, blues singer, bowing, scraping, smiling in everybody's face. That man undermined us, you and me. The description of the man that did the shooting fit C.J. You saw him sneak in here yourself. Nah, don't be fooled. That yes sir boss is hiding something. Niggas ain't like that today. It's 1943. He shot that white boy. Oh, what the fuck?
What?
Okay. What you gonna do now, boy? You don't hit a non-commissioned officer.
Sarge, he didn't mean
it. Shut up! Take him out of here, Wilkie.
Nigga like that can't have a mother. No, I seen something. CJ was asleep when I came in. It's Waters! Can't y'all see that? I seen him before. See, we got them down in Alabama. You see, old white man give him a little ass job as a servant, close to the big house. And when the boss ain't looking, old copycat nigga act like they the new owner. You see, they take to sounding like the boss. Shouting, ordering people around. But when it comes to you and me, they sell us to continue faith. You see, they think the high jail is like that. Shh. Arresting CJ, that'll get Waters another strike. And next it'll be you or you. And it can't look good unless he's standing on you. Cobb told him CJ was in all evening. Waters didn't even listen. Shit. Turning somebody in. Oh, look what I done, Captain Bounce. You see, they let him in the army because they know he'll do anything they tell him to. I seen his kind of fool before. Somebody gonna kill him.
They killed the sergeant at Fort Robinson. Recruit did it.
Kid, it'll just be our luck. Sergeant come through the whole war without a scratch.
Yeah, well, maybe. But I'm going down to the stockade and tell the MPs what I know. CJ was here all evening.
Wait, I'm coming with you.
I'm right behind you.
All right.
Could the person you thought you saw have stayed in the barracks? Did you actually see someone go out?
Yes, sir.
Was Wookie the only man out of his bunk that night?
As I recall, sir, he came in with the sergeant.
And Peterson, he did most of the talking.
I guess so. It was a long time ago, and I was juiced.
Ellis!
Yes, sir.
I want Privates Wilkie and PFC Peterson to report to me at once.
Well, he could be out on work detail, sir.
Find them.
Is there anything else, sir?
No. That's all. Send in the next man. So, Corporal Cobb reporting as ordered, sir. Have a seat, Corporal. And let's get something straight from the beginning. I don't care whether you like officers or not. Is that clear?
Sir?
I'm sorry. Did you know Sergeant Waters well?
As well as the next man, sir. I was already with the team when he took over. Me and CJ, we made the team at the same time.
Were you close to CJ?
Oh, yeah. Me and him were homies, sir. Both came from Mississippi. CJ from Carmelo. Me, I'm from up around Jetlerville, what they call Snake County. Plus, we both played for the Negro Leagues before the war.
How did you feel about his arrest?
Just terrible. CJ didn't kill nobody, sir.
He struck Sergeant Waters.
But Waters made him, sir. He called that boy things he ain't never heard of before. And CJ? He was so confused, he didn't know what else to do. And when they threw him in the stockade, he just seemed to go to pieces. And see, we both lived on farms, and even though CJ's daddy played music, CJ, he liked them wide open spaces. So that said, I started closing in on him right away. I went to see him the second day he was in there. Oh, he looked pale and ashy, sir, like something dead.
All I breathe in these little spaces, Carl. Main
wasn't made for this here. Nothing wrong. I don't think I ever see an animal in a cage again and not feel sorry for it. I'd rather be on a chain gang.
Oh, now come on, homie.
I don't know if I'm ever getting out of here, Carl. Feel like I'm going crazy. I can't walk in here. Can't see the sun. I tried singing, but nothing won't come out. I sure don't want to die in this jail.
Ain't nobody gonna die, CJ.
Yesterday, I broke a guitar string. I lost my dust. I got no protection. Nothing to keep the dog from tearing at my bones.
No, man, you stop talking crazy.
You know, he come in here last night. Sergeant Waters?
You should learn not to hit sergeants, boy. Man could get into a whole lot of trouble doing that during wartime. They're talking about giving you 5 years. They call what you did mutiny in the Navy. Mutiny, boy.
That gun ain't mine!
Oh, we know that, CJ. That gun belonged to the nigga that did the shooting down at Williams' place. Me and Wilkie found him hiding in the motor pool. He confessed his head off. Nah, see, you in here for striking a superior officer. And I got a whole barracks full of your friends to prove it.
Memphis was in charge with the shooting?
No, sir.
But don't feel bad, boy. It's not your fault entirely. It has to be this way. You see, the first war didn't change much for us. But this one's gonna change a whole lot of things. Them Nazis ain't all crazy. It's just that people can't fit into where things seem to be going. Like you, CJ. The black race can't afford you no more. Oh, there was a time when we'd see somebody like you laughing, clowning, yes sir, bossing, and we wouldn't do anything. Folks liked you. You were a good, homie kind of nigga. They needed somebody to mistreat, call a name. They paraded you. You reminded them of the good old days. Cornbread, bacon, greens and ham are cooking. Daddy out in the field picking cotton. And your grandmammy on the front porch smoking a pipe. Not anymore, boy. The day of the Geechee is gone. The only thing that'll move this race is power. That's all them whites respect. People like you make us seem like fools. We can't let anybody believe that we're like you. You bring us down. Make the whole race seem unfit. I waited a long time for you, boy. But I got you. And I try to get rid of you wherever I go. I put 2 Geechees in jail in Fort Campbell, Kentucky. 3 at Fort Huachuca. Now I got you. One less fool for the race to be ashamed of. And I'm gonna get that old boy Cobb next.
You? Yes, sir. Go on.
You imagine anybody saying something like that, Cobb? I know I ain't never getting out of here. You remember when I told you about a place I used to go to? A place right outside Carmel. And I was old. Tiny little thing. Place out behind O'Connell's farm. Place would be stanking of plums, Carl. Shaded. That ripe smell be weaving through the cotton field and clear on in the town on a warm day. first time I ever had ever. I had her under them plum trees. I wrote a song for her too. My ginger colored mama, she had thighs the size of ham. And when you spread a mama, you just let me have my jelly roll and jam. Mm-hmm. But O'Connell had a dog, meanest dog I ever did see. And in order for you to enjoy them plum trees, you had to outsmart that old dog. Waters is like that old Cobb. You had to run circles around old Wendy. That was his name. They say he tore a man's arm off once. Got the lightning. So yeah, cheat that dog out of biting you. Every time. Every time, Carl. Every time. Every time, Carl. Every time.
He just didn't make sense, sir. And I tried talking about the team and the wall, but ain't nothing work. Seemed like he just got worse.
What happened to him?
The next day, after the day I saw him, CJ, he hung himself, sir. Suicide. He just couldn't stand it. The MPs found him hung from the bars.
What happened after that?
We lost our last game. We just threw it. We did it for CJ. Captain, he was mad because we ain't get to play the Yankees. Peterson was right on that one. Somebody needed to protest that man.
What did Waters do?
Well, after we lost, the commanding officer, he broke up the team and we all got reassigned to the smoke company. And Waters, he started acting funny, sir. He stayed drunk and talked to himself all the time.
Did you think you were next?
I ain't sure I ever believed Walter said that, sir. CJ, he had to be out of his head or he wouldn't have killed himself. And Sarge, he never came near me after CJ died.
What time did you get back the night Waters was killed?
I say between 21:20 and 9:30.
And you didn't go out again?
No, sir. Me and Hanson just sat and listened to the radio too. Abbott and Costello went off, and then I played checkers with Wilkie for another hour. Then everybody went to bed. What CJ said about Walters, it ain't bothering me, sir.
Who were the last ones in that night?
Smalls and Peterson. They had guard duty.
Thank you, Corporal.
You surprised me, Davenport. I just came from Colonel Nivens, and he's given you permission to question Burton Wilcox. How did you manage that? You threatened him with an article in the Chicago Defender, I suppose.
I convinced the Colonel that it was in his best interest to allow it.
And really? Did he tell you I resist you?
I told him that I especially didn't want you.
And that is precisely why he sent me. He didn't want you to think you can get your way entirely. And not with him. Then, neither Byrd nor Wilcox would submit to it without a white officer present. That's how it is. But there's something else, Davenport. The Colonel began talking about the affidavits he and the others had signed, and about the discrepancies in their statements that night. He wants me with you to make sure Burton Wilcox won't give you the wrong impression. He never elaborated on what he meant by the wrong impression. I want to be there.
So you're not on that side anymore. You're on my side now, right?
I want whoever killed my sergeant, Davenport.
Bullshit. Yesterday you were daring me to try. And today we're allies? Besides, you don't give that much of a damn about your men. I've been around you a full day, and you haven't uttered a word that would tell me you had any more than a minor acquaintance with Waters. He managed a baseball team, was an NCO in your company, and you haven't offered any opinion on the man. As a soldier, a sergeant, platoon leader, who the hell was he?
He was one of my men, on my roster. A man these bars make me responsible for. And no, I didn't know a hell of a lot about him, or a lot of their names, or where they come from. But I'm still their commanding officer, and in a little while, I may have to trust them with my life. And I want them to know they can trust me with theirs, here and now. I have Burton Wilcox in my office. Why didn't you tell Niven she placed me under arrest?
I didn't find it necessary. What do you know about C.J. Memphis?
Well, he was a big man, as I recall. More boy than a man, though. Play guitar sometimes at the officers' club. There was something embarrassing about it. He committed suicide while he was in the stockade. He was a pretty good center fielder.
Did you investigate his arrest? The charges against him?
He was charged with assaulting a non-commissioned officer. I questioned him. He didn't say much. He admitted that he struck Waters. I started questioning several of the men in the platoon. Killed himself before I could finish. It's an open and shut case.
I think Waters tricked Memphis into assaulting him.
Waters wasn't that kind of a man. I mean, he admitted he might have provoked the boy. He accused him of that Golden Palace shooting. Listen, Waters didn't have a fifth grade education. He wasn't a schemer. And colored soldiers aren't devious like that.
What do you mean we aren't devious?
You're not as devious. And anyway, what does that have to do with this? Captain Davenport, you both been briefed by Colonel Nippes to give the captain your full cooperation.
They tell me you're a lawyer, huh?
I'm not here to answer your questions, Lieutenant. And I'm Captain Davenport. Is that clear?
Captain, is he crazy?
You've got your orders.
Sir, I vigorously protest as an officer.
You answer him the way he wants you to, Bird, or I'll have your ass in a sling so tight you won't be able to pee, soldier.
When did you last see Sergeant Waters?
The night he was killed. But I didn't kill him. I should have blown his head off the way he spoke to me and Captain Wilcox here.
And how did he speak to you, Captain?
Well, he was very drunk. He said a lot of things that he shouldn't have. I told the lieutenant here not to make the situation worse, and he agreed. And we left the sergeant on his knees, wallowing in self-pity.
What exactly did he say?
Some pretty stupid things about us. I mean, white people, sir.
What kind of things?
He said he wasn't going to obey no white man's orders. Not me and Wilcox here are to blame for him being black and not able to sleep or keep his food down. And I didn't even know the man. Never even spoke to him before that night.
Anything else?
Well, he said he'd kill somebody.
Did he call a name? Say who?
Not that I recall, sir.
No. Look, the goddamn Negro was disrespectful. He wouldn't salute, wouldn't come to attention. And where I come from, colored don't talk the way he spoke to us. Not to white people, they don't.
Is that the reason you killed him?
I killed nobody! I said where I come from, didn't I? You'd be dead yourself where I come from,
But I didn't kill the Negro.
But you hit him, didn't you?
I knocked him down.
And when you went to look at him, he was dead, wasn't he?
He was alive when we left.
Liar, you beat Waters up, you went back and you shot him.
No! But you better get out of my face before I kill you!
Like you killed Waters?
No! Dozer! He's trying to put it on me!
Answer his questions, Lieutenant.
You were both coming off bivouac, right?
Yes.
So you both had weapons.
So what? We didn't fire them.
Were the weapons turned in immediately?
Yes, sir. Colonel Nivens took our 45s to Major Hines. It was all kept quiet because the colonel didn't want the colored boys to know that anyone white from the fort was involved in any way. Ballistics cleared them.
We can check.
Go ahead.
I don't believe it. Why wasn't I told?
The weapons had cleared. And the colonel felt if you were any further involved, you would have taken the matter to Washington. Then there'd be a scandal about colored and white soldiers. Well, as it turned out, he thinks you went to Washington anyway. I'd like to say, Captain, that neither Lieutenant Byrd or myself had anything whatsoever to do with Sergeant Waters' death. I swear that as an officer and a gentleman. He was on the ground when we left him, but very much alive.
Consider yourselves under arrest, gentlemen.
On what charge?
Murder. You think I believe
that? Let them go, Captain.
But you've got motive. A witness to them being at the
scene. Let them go. This is still my investigation. You two are dismissed.
Are we being charged, sir?
Not by me.
Thank you.
I expected more from a white man, Captain.
Get out of here before I have you cashiered out of the Army, Bird. Matter with you? You could have charged both of them. Byrd for insubordination, Wilcox tampering with the evidence.
Neither charge is murder. You think Wilcox would tell a story like that if he didn't have Hines and Nivens to back it up? They've got a report.
So what do you do now?
Finish the investigation.
They're lying, damn it. And so is the colonel. You were ordered to investigate and charge the people responsible. Charge them. I'll back you up.
I am not satisfied yet, Captain.
I am. Damn it! I wish they sent someone else. You're afraid. You thought you'd come here and accuse the Klan, didn't you? That would be the end of it, right? Another story of Midnight Riders for your Negro press. But now it's officers, white men in the Army, and it's too much for you. What will happen when Captain Davenport comes up for promotion to major if he accuses white officers, right?
I am not afraid of white men, Captain.
Then why the hell won't you arrest them?
Because I do what the facts tell me, Captain, not you.
You don't know what a fact is, Davenport!
Beg your pardon, Captain?
What is it, Corporal?
Oh, this is Captain Davenport. We found Private Wilkie. We haven't located Private Peterson yet, but it seems that him and Private Smalls went out to detail last night. And neither one of them showed up. But I have a few from the guys from the company looking from around the NCO club and the PX, sir.
Where's Wilkie?
Well, he's waiting for you out back in the barracks.
Thank you.
Did you question Wilkie and Peterson yesterday? Davenport? Don't you ignore me!
Get off my back! What I do, how I do it, and who I interrogate is my business. This investigation is mine. Mine!
Don't you treat me with that kind of contempt. I'm not some redneck cracker.
And I'm not your yes sir and colored boy either.
I asked you a question.
And I don't have to answer it.
Indeed you don't. Captain.
Now,
Captain, what if Bird and Wilcox are telling the truth?
Neither one of us believe that.
What if they are?
Well then, who the hell killed the goddamn man?
I don't know yet. Is there anything else?
No, Hotshot. Nothing.
When'd you lose your stripes?
Well, a couple of months before they broke up the team, sir.
Right after Sergeant Waters was assigned.
You nervous, Wilkie?
Well, I couldn't figure out why you called me back, sir.
You lost your stripes for being drunk on duty. Is that correct?
Yes, sir.
You said Waters busted you, didn't you?
Well, he had me busted. He reported me to the captain.
And how did you feel? That must have been awful. Weren't you and the sergeant good friends? Didn't you say he was all right, a nice guy?
Yes, sir.
So when a nice guy got a friend busted?
No, sir.
So you lied when you said he was a nice guy, right?
Well, no, sir. I mean...
Speak up. Speak up. Was the sergeant a nice guy or not?
Well, you wouldn't turn somebody in over something like that, sir.
Not a good friend, right?
Well, no. A friend would give you extra duty or call you a bunch of names. You'd expect that, but... Three stripes, sir? It took 10 years to get in this army. 10 years. I started off
mad,
yeah,
man.
Made me mad all the things I did for him.
That's right. You was assistant, weren't you?
Yes, sir.
You managed the team.
Yes, sir.
You ran all his errands. You looked at his family snapshots.
Yes, sir.
You put the gun under CJ's bunk.
What? No.
Liar.
No, sir.
It was you Henson saw Wilkie, wasn't it?
No, sir.
Liar, you lied about Waters and you're lying now. You were the only man out of the bunk that night, and the only one who knew the place well enough to go straight to CJ's. Not even Henson knew the place that well. Henson didn't see who it was, but he saw what the person did. He was sure about that. Only you knew the barracks in the dark.
It was the Sarge, sir. He ordered me to do it. He said I'd get my stripes back. He's just trying to scare that boy, CJ. Let him stew in jail for a little while, but then CJ killed himself and he hit him. He had him right where he wanted him.
Why you pick Memphis?
He despised you, Captain. He had to hide it though, but underneath it was a crazy hate. He go cold when he talked about CJ. You could feel it.
He's the kind of boy that seems innocent, Wilkie. Got everybody on the post believing he's a strong black buck. He hits home runs. White boys envy his strength, speed, the power in his swing. Then this colored champion lets them same white boys call him Shine or Sambo down at the club. They laugh at his blues music. He don't care. Can't talk. Could barely read or write his own name. He'll tell you that they like him. Or that colored folks ain't supposed to have but so much sense. Do you know the damage one ignorant Negro could do? We were in France during the First War. France! We won decorations! But them white boys told all them French girls that we had tails. And they found this one ignorant colored soldier. And they paid him to tie a tail to his ass and parade around naked, making monkey sounds. And they sat him at this big round table at the Café Napoléon. Put a reed in his hand, a crown on his head, and a blanket over his shoulders. And they made him eat bananas in front of them French girls. Them white boys dance that night. And then they handed out this pamphlet with his picture on it. Called him Moonshine, King of the Monkeys. He slit his throat. That fool asked us what he had done wrong. My daddy told me we have to turn our back on his kind. Close ranks on a cornbread, collard green, and chitlin style. We're men, soldiers, and I don't intend to let my race lose its place of honor and respect in this war because of fools like CJ. I want you to watch everything he does. Everything.
And I watched him too. But Sarge, he couldn't wait. All he talked about was CJ this, CJ all the time.
Hey, CJ. CJ, come on, man.
Why didn't he pick Peterson? They fought.
Yeah, they fought, but Peterson fought back and Sarge admired that. Sarge thought Peterson would make a fine soldier, so he promoted him. Imagine that.
What was Peterson's reaction when CJ died?
Well, like the rest of us, he was sad. He put together that protest. It broke up the team. But after that, he ain't say much. And he was good for running off at the mouth all the time. He just kept to himself, all with Smalls.
What time did you get in the night Waters was killed?
About 9:45. Got back from the club. Played some checkers and listened to the radio. Sir, I didn't mean to do what I did. It wasn't my fault. He promised me not stripes.
Placing you under arrest, Private.
Oh, loudy, loudy, loudy. Did you hear, sir? Our orders. You just came down from Washington. You are shipping out. They fighting on that Eagles fighting the war.
Actually, they ain't got a chance.
And sure. You want to know something? I'm gonna win this mother in 6 months now. I know what Jesse always does to the people. Joe Louis.
Did you hit?
Hey!
Who do you know for standby alert?
Going in the combat. Watch out, Hitler. The next is coming to get your ass to the fall.
Hey, man, we're real rifles this time.
You know something? It's really okay.
Man, they tell me they're women in England.
They gonna let us get in.
Yeah.
We made like so much smoke, the Germans may never get to see what a colored soldier looks like till the war's over. Hey, Higgy, I wrote my woman just the other day that we be gone soon.
Go on. Man, you ain't wrote nothing. If the army said we was discharged, you say you wrote that.
You hear this, boy, sir.
Corporal?
Yes, sir.
Escort Private Wilkie to the stockade.
Yes, sir.
Wilkie's under arrest, sir? How come? I apologize, sir. I didn't mean it.
Do either of you know where Smalls and Peterson can be located?
Your men got Smalls in the stockade, sir.
When?
I saw two colored MPs taking them through the main gates just a while ago. I was on my way over there.
And hup! As you were. And by the way, congratulations.
Hey! Watch out, Hitler!
The nigga is coming to get your ass! Do the bomb! Do the bomb!
How you gonna let him out?
Man, it's about time. Come on, Cal!
Soldier?
Private Anthony Small, sir.
At ease. Answer my question.
I didn't go AWOL, sir. I I got drunk and tired and I fell asleep at the bus depot. It was the only public place I could find to sleep at all.
Where'd you get drunk? Where in Tynan?
Jake's and Lily's Golden Slipper on Melville Street.
Weren't you and Peterson supposed to be on detail? Where was Peterson?
I don't know, sir.
You're lying. You just walked off your detail and Peterson did nothing.
No, sir. He warned me, sir. He said, listen, Smalls.
You trying to make a fool of me, Smalls? Huh? Are you?
No, sir.
The two of you went AWOL together, didn't you? Answer me.
Yes.
You left together because Peterson knew I would find out the two of you killed Waters, didn't you? What? I can't hear you. I want an answer. Did you kill Sergeant Waters?
I can't sleep, sir. I just can't sleep.
Did you kill Sergeant Waters?
It was Peterson, sir. I watched. It wasn't me. We were changing the guard.
You can't be trusted, no matter what we do. And there's no guarantees, and your mind won't let you forget it. No.
I went back to the captain's office. Well, Sarge, he was just on the road. We just walked into him. He was ranting and acting crazy, sir.
Hey, Smoke. Look who's drunk on his ass, boy.
I told him to forget Waters.
No. I'm gonna enjoy this. Big bad Sergeant Waters. Down on his knee. No, sir. I'm gonna love this.
Hey, Pete.
Hey, Sarge. You need some help?
Yeah. Hand me up, Pete.
That's the kind of help I'm gonna give you, boy.
I know. Hey. Hand me up.
Here.
Hand me up.
Let me help you again.
Hand me up. Yeah. Come on.
You like that, huh? Huh?
Stop it.
Huh?
Stop.
You like that? Don't. No.
No.
Oh.
Stop it.
Small, some people. If it was a German, would you kill it? If it was Hitler, or that fucking Tojo, would you kill it?
There's a trick to it, Peterson. That's the only way you could win. CJ couldn't make it. He was a clown. A clown in blackface. A nigger. You have to be like them, Pete. And I was. I was. But the rules are fixed. Listen, it's CJ. CJ and his music. I made him do it. It don't make a difference. They still hate you.
Justice Smalls.
That isn't justice.
For CJ.
They still hate you!
You call that justice?
No, sir.
So why the fuck didn't you do something?
I was just scared of Peterson. Just scared of him. I tried to get him to go. but he wanted to drag the sergeant's body into the woods. He said everybody think white people did it.
What happened after that?
Well, I got sick, sir. And when Pete was done, he helped me back to the barracks and told me to be quiet. But sir, I'm sorry. Sir.
Peterson was apprehended a week later in Alabama. Colonel Nivens called it just another black mess of cutting, slashing, and shooting. He was delighted there were no white officers mixed up in it. And his report to Washington characterized the events surrounding Waters' murder as the usual common violence any commander faces in Negro military units. It was the kind of mess that turns up on page 3 in the colored papers. The Cain and Abel story of the week. The headline we Negroes can't quite read in comfort. For me, 2 colored soldiers are dead, 2 on their way to prison. The case got little attention. The details were filed in my report, and I was quickly and rather unceremoniously ordered back to my MP unit. A style of guitar picking and a dance called the CJ caught on for a while in tiny saloons during 1945. In northern New Jersey, through a military foul-up, Sergeant Waters' family was informed that he had been killed in action. The sergeant was therefore thought and unofficially rumored to have been the first colored casualty of the war from the county, and under the circumstances, declared a hero. Nothing could be done officially, but his picture hung on a wall of honor at the Doris Miller VFW post number 978. The men of the 221st, Chemical Smoke Generating Company, the entire outfit, officers, and enlisted men were wiped out in the Ruhr Valley during a German advance. Captain.
Davenport, I see you got your man.
Oh, I got him. What is it, Captain?
Will you accept my saying? You did a splendid job.
I'll take the praise, but how did I manage it?
Damn it, Davenport. You didn't come here to be made fun of. The men, the regiment, we all ship out for Europe tomorrow, and
you can't even say goodbye, Captain?
I was wrong, Davenport. About the bars, about the uniform, about Negroes being in charge. I guess I'll have to get used to it.
Oh, you'll get used to it. You can bet your ass on that. You will get used to it.
Thank you. trouble for his Uncle Sam. It really brought him down because he couldn't jam. The captain seemed to understand, because the next day the cap went out and drafted a band. And now the company jumps when he plays reveille. He's the boogie-woogie bugle boy of Company B. A toot, a toot, a toot, a toot, he blows it eight to the bar. In boogie rhythm, he can't blow a note unless the bass and guitar is playing with him. He makes the company jump when he plays reveille. He's the boogie-woogie bugle boy of Company B. He was a boogie-woogie bugle boy of Company B. And when he plays boogie-woogie bugle, he was busy as a buzz bee. And when he plays, he makes the company jump a to the bar. He's a boogie-woogie bugle boy of Company B. Do-do-do-do-da-da-do-da-da. Toot-toot, he blows it a to the bar. He can't blow a note if the bass and guitar isn't with him. And the company jumps when he plays reveille. He's a boogie woogie bugle boy of Company B. Sleep with Boogie every night and wakes them up the same way in the early bright. They clap their hands and stamp their feet because they know how he plays when someone gives him a beat. He really breaks it up when he plays.
Surrounding us, and hey, the colonel must know nobody color killed the man.
It is a precaution, Cobb. We can't have revenge killing, so we search for weapons.
Where did they find the sergeant, sir?
In the woods out by the junction. And so there aren't any rumors. Sergeant Waters was shot twice. We don't know that he was lynched. Twice. Once in the chest, and a bullet in the head. You finished the foot lockers?
Yes, sir. There aren't any weapons.
I didn't think there would be. At ease, men! Tech Sergeant Waters, in my opinion, served the 221st in this platoon in particular with distinction. And I, for one, shall miss the man. But no matter what we think of the sergeant's death, we will not allow this incident to make us forget our responsibility to this uniform. We are soldiers, and our war is with the Nazis and the Japs, not the civilians of Tainan. Any enlisted man found with unauthorized weapons will be immediately subject to summary court-martial. The Sergeant Waters' replacement will not be assigned for several weeks. Until that time, you will all report to Sergeant Dorsey and C Company. Any questions? Corporal Cobb will be Barris NCO.
Who do they think did it, sir?
At this time, there are no suspects.
You know the Klan did it, sir.
Were you an eyewitness, soldier?
Well, who else go around killing Negroes in the South? They lynched Jefferson the week I got here, sir. And the Signal Corps got dangled 2 months later.
Henson! Unless you saw it, you will keep your opinions to yourself. Is that clear? And that's an order. It also applies to everybody else!
Yes, sir!
You men who have detail this afternoon, report to the orderly room for your assignments. The rest of you are assigned to the colonel's quarters. Clean up your tail. Cobb, I want to see you in my office at 1350 hours.
Yes, sir.
As of about 600 hours this morning, the town of Tynan is placed off limits to all military personnel.
Oh, come on, man.
The Friday night dance has also been canceled.
Okay.
Some of the officers are going to the colonel. I can't promise anything. Right now, it's canceled.
Tear up!
As you were.
Hey, they still out there, Wilkie?
Yep, they got the whole place around.
What the hell they think we going to town with? Mops and ditch rats?
Y'all new recruits know what the colonel's cleanup detail is, don't you? Shoveling horse shit in his stable.
Ain't no different from what we been doing.
Made you barracks commander in chief, huh? Now don't get like old Stoner.